A reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord God said, "It is not good for the man to be alone. I will make a suitable partner for him." So the Lord God formed out of the ground various wild animals and various birds of the air, and he brought them to the man to see what he would call them. Whatever the man called each of them would be its name. The man gave names to all the cattle, all the birds of the air, and all the wild animals, but none proved to be the suitable partner for the man. So the Lord God cast a deep sleep on the man, and while he was asleep, he took out one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. The Lord God then built up into a woman the rib that he had taken from the man. When he brought her to the man said, "This one, at last, is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. This one shall be called woman, for out of her, man, this one has been taken. That is why a man leaves his father and mother and clings to his wife, and the two of them become one body." The word of the Lord. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. I urge you, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God, your spiritual worship. Do not conform yourselves to this age, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and pleasing and perfect. Let love be sincere, hate what is evil, hold on to what is good. Love one another with mutual affection. Anticipate one another in showing honor. Do not grow slack in zeal. Be fervent in spirit. Serve the Lord. Rejoice in hope. Endure in affliction. Persevere in prayer. Contribute to the needs of the holy ones. Exercise hospitality. Bless those who persecute you. Bless and do not curse them. Rejoice with those who rejoice. Weep with those who weep. Have the same regard for one another. Do not be haughty, but associate with the lowly. Do not be wise in your own estimation. Do not repay anyone evil for evil. Be concerned for what is noble in the sight of all. If possible, on your part, live at peace with all. The word of the Lord.
TJ, Lisa, are you here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage?
Yes.
Will you love and honor each other as husband and wife for the rest of your lives?
Yes.
Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up in the way of Christ and his church?
Yes.
Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, I ask you now to declare your consent before God and his church. I'm Elisa, take you, Taj. I'm Elisa Kimberly, take you, Taj Joseph.
I'm Elisa Kimberly, take you, Taj Joseph.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you. In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you and honor you.
I will love you and honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
I, Todd Joseph, take you, Melissa Kimberly, to be my wife.
I, Todd Joseph, take you, Melissa Kimberly, to be my wife.
I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad.
I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad. In sickness and in health.
I will love you and honor you all the days of my life.
I will love you and honor you all the days of my life. Lisa Kimberly,
take this ring,
as a sign of my love and fidelity.
In
the name of the Father,
and of the Son,
and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
God, Joseph.
Take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity.
Take this ring as a sign of my love and my fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
Of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
Now beginning their life together, that they may have divine assistance at every moment, the constant support of friends, the rich blessing of children, a warm love, reaching out to others, and good health until a ripe old age.